him. Jesus. And you already said you believe that Jesus ransomed his life for our life. So you've confessed it and you believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead. That means you're saved. You're saved because you confessed. First, you confess Lord Jesus. You have to acknowledge the Lord Jesus. You have to acknowledge the Son of God. You have to acknowledge who Jesus is. No man coming to the Father unless they come through Jesus. So you have to confess. You have to confess, first of all, that you believe Lord Jesus. Then you have to believe it. You have to believe with what you're confessing. Because a lot of times we'll say a lot of things, but we don't always believe what we say. Oh no, we don't. Don't even try. I know I don't. I don't believe everything I say. I don't believe it. Not everything. Not everything. But when it hits the heart, that's different. That's a whole different ball game. That's a whole different game right there. So when you look at Romans 10 and 9 and you say, I'm saved, when you have your daily walk with Christ, and you say, I'm saved, that means you're believing that in your heart. And in order to believe that, you have to be obedient to the word to believe that. That does not involve you just saying that you believe in your heart. For you to actually believe it in your heart, you are obedient to the word. You are obedient to the word. So do you believe that because verse 10 goes on to say in Romans 10 that for it is with your heart that you believe into righteousness. It's all about the heart. It's all about a heart transplant. You gotta have a heart transplant. Either you need to be a triple bypass, a double bypass, a quadruple, triple, 10 times bypass, whatever it may be, but you gotta have a heart transplant. Because it's all about the heart. It's all about the heart. It's not about what you do. It's not about how you look. It's not about what, how you try to impress someone else. It's not even about your title. God don't care about your title. He does not care about what you got. He don't care about your talents. He gave them to you. Why would he care? They're already his. He cares about your heart. It's all about the heart. He gave us the heart, but he's so good he gave us free will. He allowed us to decide what we're going to do with it. We're either going to waste it or have a heart attack. We're going to have a heart attack. So what do you really believe? Do you believe in what you see? See, sometimes that's what messes with our heart, these eyes. These eyes will get us every time. I have to see. I have to see it with my own eyes to believe it. It's not real if I don't see it. The eyes will tell you the truth, right? I gotta see it with my eyes. We ain't never seen God, but you call on God. Have you seen it with your eyes? What have you seen? What do you believe in? You gotta see it with your eyes, but get your heart. Do you really believe? Because I'm gonna go somewhere with that. Give me a minute. I'm gonna go somewhere with that because your eyes will get you in trouble. These two things right here, for me, I got four. You don't see them, but there's another two in there. You don't see them. I got four. These eyes will mess you up. I'm telling you something else gonna mess you up. Or do you believe with your heart? Because the other thing that will mess you up is what you hear. Is what you hear. Do you believe with your ears? Well, that's what I heard. You didn't even see it. But that's what sister so-and-so, cousin, brother-in-law, girlfriend told me. That's what I heard. And now you got it all over Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, LinkedIn, everybody else, because reality has become what you believe. That's what you heard. I tell you further, you will hear everything you hear on television. Matter of fact, there's some people out here right now because they heard the weatherman say it's going to be the storm. But look at God. I'm so glad that God proved that he is a Most High. Because it's not what you heard. It's not what you saw. It's what, okay, you want to see something? If you want to believe God is real, then you listen to what the God, what that weatherman said. Go out there, use your eyes and see the sunshine. And you can believe that God is the Most High and he is the one that controls the weatherman. So I tell you, family and friends, action. Love is what love does. But you gotta feel it. You gotta feel it to do it. You got to have love in your heart. You got to feel that you've been loved. You can do a lot of stuff. You can buy, I see people try to buy love, but buy love. It won't buy. It doesn't work for me. I don't need love. I got money. I can get what I want to get. So it's about feeling at that point. I got to feel something. You can't see that, but you believe in it. Everybody want to be loved, right? You need to tell me that you got to see it. Somebody got to buy it for you. Somebody got to buy you some love. My subtopic is, do you believe all the way? Do you believe all the way? You can say you believe, but I'm telling you, we will find out, okay? Now, three claims, three, and then I'm going to sit down. Three claims you have to believe. And before I get there, let me tell you, it's about a spiritual position. Because first of all, you need to establish a spiritual position. And if you don't know what that is, okay. That's easy. Too easy.
Well.
Like Bible study, Sunday school, on Sundays, worship service on Saturdays, you know, fellowship with your sisters and brothers. That spiritual position, it is a spiritual lifestyle.
All right.
It is, in the military, we have positions, and then we have what we call a branch. And it doesn't matter what job that I get. I can go anywhere in this world and I can do that branch. Anywhere I go, any job, because it's the lifestyle.
Well,
position I am in right now is temporary. It's only until 2021 as a commander. A commander position is temporary. I'm so glad of that. Ooh, thank you, Lord. Jesus. I don't know about, 2.5 years.
Yes,
man.
But the spiritual position. See, we have to establish that first. You got to establish your spiritual position. That is your relationship with God. For you to understand your spiritual position, you're going to have to first establish your spiritual relationship with God. And in order to do that, you've got to pray. You got to continue talking to God. You got to meditate in His Word. When you see that is turning you away, that is drawing you away from God, you've got to get yourself back. Focus on God. You have to establish that relationship. A lot of you say, Lord, don't turn. Lord is not, He is not leaving you. He didn't turn from you. You did. You turned from Him. So to establish that relationship, you've got to turn back around and look up to Him. Hold your head up. Stop looking down there. Down there. Why are you looking down there? Look up here. Grow spiritually. Come out on Wednesday nights and learn who God is. Because in order for you to establish that relationship, you got to know who you're establishing it with. In our natural life, we spend months and weeks months and years before we even get married because we want to know who that person is. But then we don't want to spend time with God and know who He is. About anyone in here. So when we finish, y'all can just take that to your next door neighbors and your friends and let them know that I was talking about them. Amen. Because I think that you all, I really do think that everyone in here had already established that spiritual relationship. Because that spiritual position is where your spiritual growth will be. It is where it will make you strong. In those trials and those tribulations, it is your daily spiritual lifestyle. Your spiritual position is who you are in your relationship with God. You establish your spiritual position. God doesn't give that to you. He's already gave you so much. He gave you His Son. What more do you want? You want to send somebody else? I don't think that's going to happen. Don't look at me. Cross, not putting nails like that. Yeah, so what more do you want?
All right.
Well, so now is Verse 30.
Amen.
In verse 30 of the text, all right, John tells us that the disciples told Jesus,
all right,
"We can now see that you know all things,
yes,
and you do not even need anyone to ask you questions."
Amen.
This makes us believe that you came from God. Now, if you all, you're familiar with the scripture, you all know that at this point, we are about to go to the time where Jesus is about to, we're closing in on the days of his time here on earth.
Yes,
yes, yes. So at this point, by now, Christ has actually said a lot of things.
Well.
He's done a lot of things. He said, "Do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be worried about itself." He has even said that, "As the Father has loved me, I will also love you."
Yes, yes, yes.
He also said, "Blessed are the merciful, for they shall be shown mercy."
All right.
He even said, "Know who I am, and that I am
always."
Not sometimes, because see, sometimes we think we on this journey alone. We think we doing this all by ourselves, and we walk around and we think that nobody cares, and oh poor old me, I'm so sad because I'm just in this alone. But he said, "I am with you always." See, Christ has said all that, but I'm telling you something. Not only did he say, "I'm the way, the truth, and the life," but this is the part that gets me. Now, the disciples been with him all this time. He's been saying a lot of stuff. But the thing that, you know, is when he spoke, his words were powerful.
Amen.
So, if he spoke, his word, Jesus actually spoke for Lazarus to be raised from the dead. People saw that. People saw that. He spoke. He had to, his word, his voice, his word, it was so powerful that he had to actually call him by name. See, that's how it is with some of you. God is calling some of you by name. He's actually calling you by name to lift you up out of that bad situation. But you want to stay right down there in that darkness, wrapped up in all that stuff, dead. And he's trying to call, he has called your name, by name. But Jesus, his word was so powerful that he even spoke Lazarus' name and rose this man who's been dead for a pretty long time, 4 days. And if you ever see people dead for you, you all know. I don't know. Yes, I am. That stinks. That smells. That body is beginning to decompose. But Jesus spoke and Lazarus came back to life. That right there
enough.
When the disciples said, "We now believe," I'm like, you didn't believe when he rose Lazarus from the dead? You didn't believe when he cast the demons out? You didn't believe when he prayed over a happy meal and fed 5,000 people? You didn't believe? You didn't believe when he turned water, pure water? I'm telling you, I didn't know her. He didn't even go get it himself. He had somebody else go get it to make sure they understood it was water. And he turned that water to wine. And they just believed. So I don't know what Jesus said, but whatever he said, it struck their hearts. He said something that caused them to say, "This." It struck their heart. This makes us believe. So everything that you heard over the last 7 days, what is it? Has your heart been struck? What has to be said for you to know your spiritual position in faith? Do you have the faith? You say I have the faith, but do you have the faith? What has to strike your heart to have the faith in Christ Jesus? Do you really have the faith? Because when those struggles, those trials, when that pain hits your body, when you lose your job, when the electricity is turned off, when you don't know where you're going to lay your head the next day, when the kids are picking on you in school and bullying you, when you are running from fear, when you are going this way and going that way, where is your faith? You say, "I have faith," but do you really have faith? Do you really have faith? Do you have faith in your heart, or are you just trying to talk yourself in disbelief? Are you in so much denial that that's the only thing you can say with your mouth? See, you got to understand your spirit. spiritual position in faith.
Amen.
And faith, just in case you didn't know,
is
believing in that which you cannot see. See, that's what faith is. See, that's the reason why I say these eyes will get you in trouble. Because we lose our faith because we can't see it. We start not trusting God, and we start losing that faith because it's just not happening. I just don't see it, Lord. I don't see that increase. I don't see the check. There's no check in the mail. Here it is, April 20th, and that income check hasn't come yet, Lord. Where is the check? I don't see it, Lord. The car's still broken down. It's down the road. We start looking. We start seeing. Our eyes will get us in trouble. Where is the faith? Do you have faith?
Amen.
The revival is what you believe in.
Uh-huh.
And the number one thing that you're going to have to go now, because the revival is almost over.
Yes.
Do you have faith? How many more revivals you got to do that pound that in? That's in your heart.
Yes.
That's in yours. Yes. God will give you the heart transplant if you need it. But now you got to ask yourself, I have to know what my spiritual position is in faith.
Amen. All right.
Yeah. Spiritual
position.
Your revival is in your belief.
Yeah.
If you believe your spiritual position in faith, you will conduct yourself according to God's word by believing that God is.
God is.